Hey guys, this is Dr. Luisa here, showing you how to make a paper RPG that looks something like this, like that, and then the little exploding part, you can say. I don't know what that's called. It looks like that. Looks like that. So this is the whole thing. It's probably around 2 feet, maybe. Maybe about 3. I don't know. That's the whole thing. So yeah. So. And the base. You can go on your shoulder like this. It can't shoot very far. Whoa, thank you, my bunny's cage. My bunny's cage is just to save me from falling back. Oh yeah, I can't shoot far. Let me see if I can. So I'll show y'all how this is. I don't know if you guys want to look at this tutorial or not, but I'll need about 5 or 6 pieces of paper and somewhere around 20 pieces of tape. So yeah, so get a piece of paper, and now I'm going to do the whole gun first, and then if I have to, part 2 for the exploding part. But yeah, so you take one piece of paper. And you just roll it like that. Okay. Get a piece of tape and tape it. I mean, it doesn't have to be too tight, but I'm really not too loose. I mean, the bullet doesn't go in all the way, not the bullet, but the exploding part. It doesn't go in all the way at the end and then shoot through. So, I mean, I prefer making it skinny, like, that the exploding part can just, like, slip in there. And who knows, maybe yours will be able to shoot farther than mine. And then you just do the same thing. Put that tube, put it in another piece of paper. And roll that up. I mean, you don't want the tubes the same exact size because you will stick the tubes inside of each other. So, tape this. So yeah. And then slip out the first tube that was in it. And now the first tube can fit into the second tube. And then you're going to use the second tube to make the third tube. That's same. Well, not same size, but the same way. So then take the second tube, hopefully fatter, and get another piece of paper and fold it up the same way. And by now your barrel, like, should be getting pretty big. Tape that, put a piece right in the middle, and then put a piece top and end. Doesn't have to be the neatest thing in the world, you know. Okay, and then slip out the tube that's inside of that tube, which can hopefully come out because mine's having a little bit of trouble. Ah, there we go. And now all three of those long way tubes can hopefully fit inside of each other. They should if you rolled them up the way I did. And then you take a piece of paper and fold it up like this. The opposite way. Now you only need to make one of these. Make the handle kind of skinny, you know. Save that. Tape it in the middle and top The pieces don't have to be incredibly huge. No, they could be super skinny, so that you're not actually wasting too much tape. You can make more of my creations. Now, I was watching a video after I made this, and I noticed that this port is actually made very similar. Like, now, I don't know if it's similar, but like, when you're done making it, it'll look something like this. I didn't watch the whole video, because I was just browsing around trying to look for this. But, the guys watching this that made this, little exploding part. I don't mean to copy you, but, it's really easy to make. You get another piece of paper, and you fold it in half. Get a pair of scissors, and on that piece, you cut it, or you can zip it. It don't really matter. I like scissors because they're faster. Might not be faster, but definitely neater. And can be faster, too, so yeah. And you will need both halves. And then this is just like making a paper bullet, like an actual, not a shotgun shell, but an actual paper bullet. As you can see, it looks like two of them taped together. So yeah, so you take half of them and you do this. Hold it like this, take one corner like this and fold it. Make sure it's pretty big, so fold it in maybe somewhere around there. And then just don't fold it up, just fold it mainly in. Tape that. It doesn't have to be the tightest thing in the world. Like, mine ain't that tight. It's more loose than it is tight. So, yeah. And now, as you can see, this looks a lot like a paper bullet. It has that cone shape. And now, there's no perfect way to match them. So just take another piece of paper, fold it the same way. Try to make it as even as you can. No, it doesn't have to be that even. Cut off the extra. Okay. Now as you can see, I have two pieces. Try to put them inside of each other. And then you should have something like this. Yeah, it's not that even. But, kind of good. And then take a nice size piece of tape and just wrap it around that whole exploding part. Then put them inside of each other, or put one inside of the other. Keep it in when you're taping it. Now, it might not be the neatest, but it'll hopefully do. Now, mine's crooked. No. Yeah, I should do something like this. It might not look crooked on camera, but it is. Okay. I'm going to take your three long pieces and put a little bit into each other. It is a good thing I didn't put much in, hopefully. On the other end. Put it in a little bit. A little bit, not a lot. And then take another nice size piece of tape and tape those two pieces together. Okay. And tape the other two pieces together. Okay, and then you should have them pretty big too. Okay, and now for this little small tube compared to this huge thing. You're gonna measure it with your hand, and if your hand is smaller than half the thing, you should cut it just about in half. I just cut mine somewhere around the half, which is a figure not even, but who cares? No. So then take one piece of tape, not the biggest, and you want to make sure you have room for the shoulder, so you can put them on your shoulder, if you know you want to. That's why it's been 3 pieces. So maybe you should put one piece on the beginning of the second tube. Or the end, you know. It doesn't really matter. Okay. So I just put one on. And then put the other piece on maybe the third tube. Like, not really close to the other one. And then it should, pretty spaced apart, you know. Make sure they're, good enough to hold your hand. If not, put a couple extra pieces of tape on it. And then you take your bullet, or not bullet, but exploding part, and stick it in the biggest end. Like so. And then, maybe if you want, you could stick it in the smaller end. Okay. And then, it kind of sucks like shooting, but kind of good. So yeah, if you want to make more, just make 2 paper bullets, if you know how to for your paper gun. And just connect them, piece of tape, try to put one inside of the other. And also, you might want to try to tape up the end so that no air can go through. That might be pretty it kind of does if both ends are taped up. So, tape up both ends. Okay. Now, boom. And then, obviously there's no bullet, so, yeah. See you guys later, bye.